Welcome aboard, aviation enthusiast. Today, fasten your seatbelts and prepare for an interesting journey into the world of aviation's crown jewel, the Airbus A380. As the largest passenger aircraft in the skies, the Airbus A380 is not just a plane. It's a marvel of engineering, design, and innovation. Join us as we explore every aspect of this magnificent giant, from its groundbreaking inception to its unparalleled in-flight experience. Get ready to soar through the clouds and uncover the fascinating story behind the Airbus A380. The Airbus A380 is the world's largest passenger airliner and only full-length double-deck jet airliner. It was developed by Airbus in 1988 and launched in 2000. The first prototype was unveiled in 2005. And the first flight took place in 2005. Production was delayed due to the electrical issues, but it entered services in 2007 and reached 30 per year in 2012 and 2014. However, production ended in 2021 due to Emirates' reduced order. The Airbus A380 has a seating capacity of 525 passengers and has completed over 800,000 flights with no fatalities or hull losses. From 1997 to 2000, Airbus refined its design, targeting a 15-20% reduction in operating costs over the existing Boeing 747-400. The Airbus 3XX design converged on a double-decker layout, providing more passenger volume than a traditional single-deck design. In December 2000, Airbus launched a €9.5 billion project to build the Airbus 3XX, redesignated as Airbus 380, with 50 firm orders from 6 launch customers. The Airbus 380 development cost has fluctuated over the years, with estimates ranging from €9.5 billion in 2000 to €28 billion in 2016. The aircraft was initially loaned by France, Germany, and the UK to Airbus, with refundable advances reaching €7.3 billion. In 2018, Airbus revised its deal with these countries to save $1.4 billion and lower production rate. A WTO ruling in 2018 concluded that the Airbus 380 received improper subsidies, but Airbus acknowledged that the threat to Boeing is minimal. The German government is currently in talks with Airbus about outstanding loans. Europe argues that the subsidies no longer exist and no sanctions are warranted. The Airbus A380, a commercial aircraft, is built in France, Germany, Spain, and the UK. Due to its size, traditional transportation methods are not feasible, so they are transported to the Jean-Luc Lagarde plant assembly hall in Toulouse, France, using a specialized road and water transportation. Airbus 380 components are supplied by suppliers worldwide, including Rolls-Royce, Safran, United Technologies, and General Electric. The itinerary, a grand gabarit route, is used for surface movement, involving roll-on and roll-off ships, port facilities, and modified routes. The aircraft is then flown to the Airbus Hamburg Finkenwerder plant for furnishing and painting. Initial production of the Airbus A380 was troubled by delays attributed to the 530 km of wiring in each aircraft. Airbus cited as underlying causes the complexity of cabin wiring, 98,000 wires and 40,000 connectors. Its concurrent design and production, the high degree of customization for each airline, and failures of configuration management and change control. In June 2005, Airbus announced a 6-month delay in deliveries, reducing the total number of planned deliveries by the end of 2009 from 120 to 90 to 100. In June 2006, deliveries were cut to 70 to 80 aircraft. leading to a 26% drop in the share price of Airbus parent, EADS. In October 2006, Airbus CEO Christian Streiff announced a third delay, pushing the first delivery to October 2007, followed by 13 deliveries in 2008, 25 in 2009, and a full production rate of 45 aircraft per year in 2010. Freighter orders were cancelled by FedEx and United Parcel Service, who converted to Airbus 380-800 by Emirates and ILFC. Airbus negotiated a revised delivery schedule and compensation with 13 customers, all of which retained their orders. The Airbus A380 was considered a potential replacement for the existing Boeing VC-25, servicing as Air Force One presidential transport. But EADS declared that assembling only 3 planes in the US would not make financial sense. In May 2008, Airbus announced reduced deliveries for 2008 and 2009, and in 2012, it delivered 26 units, outdoing its predicted output for the first time. Let's talk about its design. The Airbus 380 was initially offered in 2 models, the Airbus 380-800 and the Airbus 380F. The Airbus 380-800 had a 3-class configuration and 853 passengers. In 2007, Airbus introduced a fewer passenger configuration for premium class accommodation. The Airbus 380-800 model has a design range of 8,500 nautical miles and can fly from Hong Kong to New York or Sydney to Istanbul non-stop. The Airbus 380F freighter was put on hold due to prioritizing passenger flights. The Airbus 380 is a modern aircraft with Rolls-Royce Trent 900 or engine Alliance GP7000 turbofan engines. It produces half the noise of Boeing 747-200 while carrying more passenger. The Airbus 380 received an award from the Noise Abatement Society in 2012. It is cheaper to land at London Heathrow than a Boeing 777-200 and 300, saving $4,300 to $5,200 per landing. The aircraft has thrust reversers on the inboard engines only, reducing debris straight up during landing. The combination of wheel braking, large spoiler, and flaps reduces the aircraft's reliance on thrust reversal, saving weight and reducing maintenance expenses. The Airbus 380 wings are designed for a maximum takeoff weight over 600 tons, but airport restrictions force a longer short for aspect ratio of 7.8, reducing fuel efficiency and increase operating costs. Airbus estimates that the Airbus 380 size and advanced technology could provide lower operation costs per passengers than the 747-400. The wings incorporate wingtip fences, increasing fuel efficiency and range by reducing induced drag and wake turbulence. The wings were designed in Filton and manufactured in Broughton, UK. The Airbus 380 is a commercial airliner with a fuselage made of aluminium alloys, with composite materials comprising over 20% of the airframe, carbon fiber, reinforced plastic, glass fiber reinforced plastic, and quartz fiber reinforced plastic are used extensively in wings, fuselage section, tail surfaces, and doors. The Airbus A380 is the first commercial airliner to have a central wing box made of carbon fiber reinforced plastic and a smoothly contoured wing cross section. Thermoplastic are used in the landing edges of slats. The hybrid fiber metal laminates material glare is used in the upper fuselage and stabilizer leading edges, offering a better corrosion and impact resistance than conventional aluminium alloys. Laser beam welding manufacturing techniques have been used to create a lighter, a stronger structure. The Airbus A380 exterior requires 3,300 liters of paint, which is 5 layers thick and weighs about 650 kilograms when dry. The Airbus A380 uses an integrated modular avionics architecture, first used in military aircraft like the Lockheed Martin F-22 Raptor and Dassault Rafale. The IMA suit developed by Airbus, FAILS, DL Aerospace, is a technological innovation with networked computing modules for various applications. The Airbus 380 flight deck features an improved glass cockpit with 8 liquid crystal displays, including flight controls, navigation, engine parameters, system and multifunction displays. The network system servers is the heart of the paperless cockpit, eliminating bulky manuals and traditional charts. Powered by wire flight control actuators are being used in civil aviation to back up primary hydraulic actuators and arguments, then during certain maneuvers. The Airbus 380 uses a 350 bar hydraulic system, reducing the weight and size of pipelines, actuators and related components. The system features titanium hydraulic lines, fuel and air-cooled heat exchangers, and self-contained electrically powered hydraulic power pack for backup. The Airbus A380 uses 450 kVA variable frequency electrical generator, aluminium power cable, fully computerized electrical power system. The auxiliary power unit APU powers the analysis ground station AGS and other auxiliary power sources. The Airbus 380-800 has 550 square meters of usable floor space, 40% more than Boeing 747-8. It features a quieter interior and higher pressurization to reduce travel fatigue, with 50% less cabin noise, 50% more cabin area and volume, larger windows, bigger overhead bins, and 60 cm more headroom than 747-400. Seating options range from 3 rooms, 12 cubic meters. Resistance in first class in 11 across in economy. The Airbus 380 upper and lower decks are connected by 2 stairways, allowing multiple seat configuration. The maximum certified carrying capacity is 853 passengers in an all-economy class layout. The Airbus 380 interior illumination system used bubble-less LEDs in the cabin, cockpit and cargo decks with HID lighting for brighter illuminations. Airbus has stressed the comfort and space of the Airbus 380 cabin, advertising on board relaxation areas such as bars, beauty salons, duty-free shops, and restaurants. Initial operator typically configured their Airbus 380 for 3-class service, adding extra features for passengers in premium cabins. The Hamburg Aircraft Interior Expo in April 2015 presented an 11-seat row economy cabin for Airbus 380, reflecting a changing economy and reluctance of employees to pay for executives to travel in first or business class. In the 1990s, the International Civil Aviation Organization, ICAO, created guidelines for larger planes, including the Airbus 380, to accommodate up to 80-meter wingspan and length. Airbus designed the Airbus 380 to operate safely on ground V runways and taxiways with a 60-meter load-bearing width. The US FAA initially opposed this, but in 2007 the FAA and EASA agreed to allow the Airbus 380 to operate on 45-meter runways without restrictions. The Airbus 380-800 is approximately 30% larger in overall size than 747-400. The Airbus 380 requires service vehicles with lift capable of reaching the upper deck and tractors capable of handling its maximum ramp weight. The ICAO recommended
provisional separation criteria for the Airbus A380 on takeoff and landing be substantially greater than 4747 due to a stronger wake turbulence. In 2006, the ICAO issued new interim recommendations, replacing a blanket 10 nautical miles separation for aircraft tailing the Airbus A380 during approach. In 2008, revised approach separation were issued, and an incident on a parallel runway during crosswind led to changes in procedure for those conditions. As the Airbus A380 fleet grows older, airworthiness authority rules require certain schedule inspections from approved aircraft tool shops. The increasing fleet size, at the time projected to reach 286 aircraft in 2020, caused expected maintenance and modification to cost $6.8 billion for 2015 to 2020, of which $2.1 billion are for engines. Emirates performed its first check Charlie for 55 days in 2014 during lengthy shop stays. Some airlines will use the opportunity to install new interiors. If you're interested to know more about maintenance check, we made this video. You can click on the cards. You can watch it on our channel. The Airbus A380, a Boeing 747 aircraft, has been ordered and delivered by 14 customers, with the largest customer being Emirates. The Airbus A380F version had attracted 27 orders before being either cancelled or converted to Airbus A380-800 due to production delays and the suspension of freighter program. Delivery takes place in Hamburg for Europe and the Middle East and in Toulouse for the rest of the world. In 2013, Airbus announced attractive discount to airline who placed large order for Airbus A380. In 2014, Airbus terminated 5 Airbus A380 firm orders from Skymark Airlines, All Nippon Airlines, and Qantas. In 2017, Emirates had 48 order outstandings, but due to lack of space in Dubai Airport, it deferred 12 deliveries by 1 year and would not take any in 2019 to 2020, before replacing its early airlines from 2021. In 2018, Airbus secured a preliminary agreement from Emirates for up to 36 Airbus A380s, valued at $16 billion at lease prices. In 2019, Emirates decided to cancel its order for 39 planes, opting to replace them with Airbus 350 and Airbus 330 neos. In October 2021, Emirates announced it would receive its final 3 Airbus 380, ending production of the Airbus 380. Thanks for watching this video up to here. If you like this video, by hit the like button and share with your friend, we support our channel and we encourage to produce more videos.